In the midst of an ongoing pandemic, or any flu season for that matter, it's always a good idea to have some hand sanitizer on you. And antimicrobial hand rubs are great. They're convenient, portable, and really effective. Pretty much every bottle of hand sanitizer features a statement saying it kills 99.99% of germs. I wish everything in my life had that kind of success rate. But what's up with that remaining 0.01%? You might assume that's there for legal purposes in case the stuff misses a germ here or there, or that it's purely marketing and nobody knows exactly how effective hand sanitizer is. Well, as it turns out, that tiny fraction of a percentage is there for a scientific reason, and there isn't enough hand sanitizer in the world to eliminate it. While there are a lot of hand sanitizer ingredients that are effective at killing germs, the most common one is alcohol. Alcohol-based hand sanitizers work by destroying the external defenses of viruses and bacteria, usually a lipid membrane or a protein shell. It's called denaturing, and it's a form of destruction specific to the microscopic components making up cells. In viruses, this means breaking down the protective membrane called a viral envelope and exposing the DNA inside to be denatured as well. In bacteria, the alcohol destroys the cell membrane and can denature specific proteins to mess with their function. Either way, this spells death for the microbe, but only at the right concentration of alcohol. Hand sanitizer needs to be at least 60% alcohol to maximize its impact on the membranes or proteins. But studies have shown that the mechanism also depends on water, so nearly pure alcohol above 90% concentration isn't as effective. But even at the right concentrations, there are some cases where alcohol isn't enough to kill all germs. There are some types of viruses and bacteria that can survive even a generous splash of hand sanitizer. These germs evade our alcohol-based attacks in a few ways. The first is by evolving resistance to it. Like the superbugs you hear about that are developing resistance to antibiotics, some bacteria have evolved resistance to alcohol. Enterococcus faecium is one of them. From the name, you can probably figure out where it hangs out. It's a gut bacterium that's commonly spread in healthcare settings. It's already resistant to many types of antibiotics, and now it's developing resistance to alcohol too. Researchers have studied the effectiveness of alcohol at killing E. faecium strains over the years and found that our favorite hand sanitizer ingredient is less effective against newer strains, particularly the ones that evolve after 2010. The genes involved in E. faecium's resistance code for some proteins that compose the cell wall and others that help the bacteria take up carbohydrates, which support the cell wall. Unfortunately for us, the bacterial cell wall is one of the first things an alcohol-based hand sanitizer will target. So the mutations E. faecium has evolved block the destructive mechanism of alcohol pretty effectively. Researchers suspect that widespread use of lower concentration alcohol hand sanitizers might have contributed to this resistance. So using stronger alcohol-based hand sanitizers might work better.
Thanks to Skillshare for supporting this video. Skillshare is the largest online learning community for creatives, with thousands of classes led by industry experts across film, illustration, design, freelance, productivity, and more. Skillshare can help you take your career, skills, hobbies, passions, or side hustles to the next level. Since you're here on YouTube, you might check out Marques Brownlee's Skillshare class on YouTube success. You can learn how to script, shoot, and edit YouTube videos from a pro. So anyone from hobbyists to professionals can achieve their goals and make awesome new videos with confidence. Skillshare is curated specifically for learning, meaning there are no ads, and they're always launching new premium classes so you can follow wherever your creativity takes you. With Skillshare, you can join classes and communities right up your alley with support from fellow creatives to accomplish real growth. And the first 500 people to click the link in the description will get a 1-month free trial of Skillshare.
Evolved resistance isn't the only way germs can evade hand sanitizers. Some have shields that are just too tough for alcohol to begin with, including the one protecting norovirus. Norovirus is a non-enveloped virus, which means its function doesn't depend on a membrane wrapped around it. Instead, it has a protein shell called a capsid that's extra difficult to break down. Enveloped viruses enter a cell by fusing their outer membrane to the cell's membrane, then releasing their contents into the cell. While this mechanism is convenient and sneaky, it makes the virus really reliant on its membrane, which is pretty flimsy compared to a capsid. These viruses spread less aggressively since they can't survive as long outside of a host body. Norovirus, on the other hand, has high defense and high attack. It penetrates cell membranes when it infects them, ripping open the membrane to get the viral RNA inside. To do this, it needs a tough-as-nails capsid that won't break apart before it gets to a host cell. Now, this might make norovirus sound like an invincible viral supervillain. But while it's super tough, it does have weaknesses. Bleach and heat. Those methods are obviously too harsh to use on ourselves, but surfaces and clothing can be disinfected with bleach or by washing and drying at high temperatures. As for your hands, it's best to wash with soap and water to eliminate norovirus, because your hand sanitizer is about as effective on this virus as asking it to go away nicely. While not all germs have strong defenses like that, there is one last way that they can survive when they come in contact with hand sanitizer. They take a nap. Let me explain. Some types of bacteria have the defense mechanism of forming spores to deal with environmental stressors. One of these is Clostridium difficile. Bacterial spores are basically a dormant form of the bacterium. Bacteria like C. diff form these spores and reduce all activity that could be disrupted by high temperatures, pH changes, and, you guessed it, alcohol. So creating spores is basically a way for the bacteria to go to sleep until things get better. The cells shut down a lot of metabolic processes and wrap up their critical components in a tough shell. Without complex processes keeping the cell running, antimicrobials only have one target, the cell wall. And as we've seen before, with a hard enough wall, alcohol doesn't have a chance. The best way to deal with C. diff spores on your body is, once again, hand washing. You basically can't destroy them, so removing them is the only option. Ultimately, hand sanitizers do work really well. Killing 99.99% of germs isn't a stat to sneeze at, and the CDC highly recommends the use of alcohol-based hand sanitizers for healthcare workers, since they're more effective than soap at actually killing germs that are susceptible to alcohol. But as we've seen, not all germs are susceptible. Some bacteria and viruses have amazing defenses, evolve their resistance, or simply turn off and don't care. Hand sanitizers don't kill most of all germs. They kill all of most germs. Until we develop something better, the surest way to stay safe from viruses and bacteria won't fit in a purse or backpack. It's the restroom sink.